Okay, so as I told them, this I am Kanishka Jain. I'll be speaking on a very interesting topic today, that is social media. As social media is the part and parcel of our life, we've been so attached to it. The time we wake up, we are on social media. Before we go to sleep, we are on social media. But today, I'll be speaking on another aspect of it, that is social media. Social media for MBAs. Okay, is my screen visible to everybody?
Yeah, it's visible.
Okay. Okay. So as it is here written that social media is not a media. It is the key to listen, engage, and build relationships. So we have seen the other side of it, but I'll be showing you the other side of the coin today. That is how you can use it for MBAs, Management of Business Administrations, how it is helpful there. So as I told, social media is not a key. It is the key to listen, to engage, and to build relationships. You can listen to people there. People put their thoughts, people put their ideas, people put their new products, you call it. And there are people who build good relationship and which are helpful in their career path as well. So this is the other side of the social media that I'll be throwing light on today. Okay, why social media? How and why social media is helpful for us? So the very first point is here, easy access. As we know, it is very easy to accessible for everybody, no matter what the age is today. From a small kid, 4-5 years kid, even knows how to use a phone and he can use social media well. And I think we the generation can help our parents to learn it. And I think we are helping them. As a generation, we are helping them to cope up with the technical gap they face. So it is easy access. It is handy. We are always on our phone and we can have easy access to everything, every aspect of it. And the second point is, can connect to a wide range of audiences. As I told, from young generation to teenagers and middle-aged people, everybody we can connect on social media. For example, if I give you an example, that there is a good ad, it is an advertisement, and there is an advertisement of a product on your mail IDs. Okay, if I drop you advertisement of my product on your mail IDs, and on the other hand, I drop it on the my friend drops it on the YouTube. He prepares a good advertisement by himself, and then he puts that in the YouTube. And just imagine which one will you be attracted? Anybody can answer. Which is the attracting feature here? Is it the email or it is the YouTube?
YouTube, obviously.
Yes, very, very correct. That is more attracting, right? We will be more attracted towards the visual, the way the person is presenting it, he's speaking about it. We won't be attracted to the email. And sometimes I guess we don't even check email until unless it is our official or that email. Only we check on them. So we can connect to a wide range of audiences here. There are open possibilities to connect directly to their customers without third-party intervention. For example, if I have a product and I don't, I don't call any of the advertisement agencies or anybody to help my product promote to them. What happens? I will directly go on social media and I will directly promote my product. I don't need any third-party intervention. It goes with the the services, not only product based but service based companies get a great help from social media. And then its advertisement is cost friendly. Just imagine there is a new company, there is a startup in the market, and definitely the startups have to keep an eye on the cost, on the budget they have decided for their startup. So as we all are aware that advertisement and printing and all cost a lot of money. So social media helps them it for free. Like if I open a page on Instagram or any other LinkedIn or Facebook, and if I promote my startup there, don't you think it will be cost friendly? It will be in my budget and it will, you know, favor my budget that I have decided for my company. So it again becomes advertisement is here cost friendly. Then increase in rankings of company. Like we all are aware of search engine optimization. If I search a company more and more and many people search about it, will it not help them to increase the ranking of the company? Yes, it will definitely help to increase the ranking of the company. So this is how social media, I answered why social media. Because social media is easy to access, can connect to a wide range of audiences and open possibilities to connect directly without third party intervention. And advertisement is cost friendly again for the startups that are there in the market. They don't have to spend their budget on advertisement, printing and all such things. They will also help in increasing rankings of a company. So this is why social media. Now coming on the main topic that we have today, that is social media and MBA. Social media and MBAs, we all are on social media, we use social media, we see various ads, we see various campaigns going on and helping people promote their product, grow their business, increase profits and increase sales. So this is how social media is helping MBAs. So the first point is there is no geographical boundaries. No geographical boundaries because, you know, we can sit here and we can connect to people in different parts of the country as well as international country, on international level as well. We can connect to, we can promote our product there as well. So there are no geographical boundaries. We can connect to a wide range of people without any limitations here. And the second point is here, the larger sales and fatter profits. As if I promote my product online, even we've been experiencing this, that if we have a product, if we see some ads, we definitely go and search for it. Don't we do that? Do we search about it? If we see any good product, any new product, we go and search about it. And if we like it, we check upon reviews and then we buy it. So is it not adding to the profits of the company? Am I right here? Is it really adding? Do we really do that, what I said now? Like we go and we check upon it and then we, if we find it is good and it is helpful, it is budget friendly, we go and buy it, right? So this is definitely increasing the sales of the company and it is increasing the profits as well for the company. Then keeping up with the current global trends. So social media is a place where we really come to know about the trends that are going currently. Like recently I read an article on social media that how the employee engagement became a challenge for HR. So that is the current trend, how employee engagement become, it became a challenge for HR managers to, they are working from home and then you have to engage them at that level because you can't keep a constant eye on them because they are working from home. So they said that employee engagement was a real challenge there. So I came to know about it from social media. So similarly, it goes for current global trends going on. The trend that was, since we've been in lockdown and due to this pandemic, we came to know that all the companies started promoting their employees to upskill themselves. Recently, even Capgemini, if you have heard about the company, even Capgemini, they tied up with Coursera for their employees to get them upskilled. So that is all the trends that I came to know from social media. So it is also helping us to, keep up with the current global trends that are going on. Then comes the marketing budget. As I said, marketing and advertisement is a huge cost that companies have to put in their money. So marketing budgets can be surely lowered from social media because they can promote their product and reach n number of people by social media marketing. Social media marketing has become a profession, if I'm not wrong, if you all are aware about it. Social media marketing is a profession now. People are going for digital marketing. People are going for social media marketing. They are hiring such people and then they, Trust me, people are earning ample amount of money. And the fifth point is communication, two-way traffic. Okay, I will like to explain this by giving an example. The example is, if I drop you a mail from my company that you are supposed to do this, blah, 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 and you are supposed to submit it on this timeline. And so this is a one-way communication, right? Definitely the other person will see it, but don't you think this is one-way communication? I want audience to answer. Isn't it one-way communication here? A company drops a mail. He/she tells you that you have to do this work. This is the timeline, and you are supposed to finish it and drop a mail regarding the same. Don't you think it is a one-way communication here? Hello. Okay, so yeah, this is definitely a one-way communication that goes on via emails. But social media again helps you to have a two-way communication. It helps the employees to put forth their points. It helps your customers as well to put forth their points and get good feedbacks, which can bring a change for your organization, for your product, which at the end, because we believe we are the ones who are, our product is there to satisfy our customer that we have. So it again becomes a two-way communication, a two-way traffic by social media. Okay, now this slide would help you as a student. If you are an MBA student, how will it help you? How social media can help you? Okay, the first point is it can help you build great, great connections. Great connections, if you have great connections, it may help you achieve your dream job. It may help you achieve higher positions. So this is how building connections can be really fruitful for your career. It can help you in career development. It can help you in personal development. It can help you get feedback from people. It can help you know about people. It can help you to know their career path. And it can help you to as well build great, great, great connections for your career. So how social media, and you know what I am talking about by building connection, the most helpful, that is LinkedIn, the most professional social media that have is LinkedIn. How you can build great connection, I personally have experienced it because I have connected to many people, and they are definitely helping me, and I am connected to them. So LinkedIn, I would suggest you to switch from Facebook to LinkedIn. LinkedIn is a great platform to showcase your talent, to showcase your skills, to showcase your professional career if you are going through, and for development that you need. It can really help you. Then we have branding. What does branding mean? Branding is to put an image of XYZ in other people's mind is branding. For example, if I take a name of Apple, it has a brand image in your minds, right? If I'm not wrong, Apple has a brand image name, then Zara, then Vero Moda, and all such stuff. They all have a brand image in our minds. So that is what branding is. But I'll be talking about here branding as in personal branding. I will, because we all are in a generation where we are on social medias, but we are currently not stick to what we have to be actually. So I would suggest you to go on LinkedIn and start branding yourself. Okay, what is personal branding? As in what I mean here, personal branding is to showcase your skills there, to create a visual there about you, to personal brand. Just don't stick to your name. Make your name a brand by using social media. Yes, you can do that. And it will surely help you to achieve higher job opportunities in your career. So this is what I mean by branding. So a simple thing that what you can do is, I would ask you to, when you wake up, don't go on Instagram, don't go on Facebook, go on LinkedIn and spend 15 minutes. At least read what people post there. Put a thumbs up. Yes, there are various ample of things, good things that you will get to know from branding. From LinkedIn. Then comes branding as an MBA student. Just now I spoke about it. Branding as an MBA student, it can help you. It is a live resume. You all are aware of it. You know, nowadays, live resume is what recruiters are looking for. When you prepare a resume, I am very much sure that you have to add your LinkedIn ID if you have. And what do? They go and check how much you are, what is your live resume. Because they stick to it. They believe in what is live resume. What are you doing? What are your skills? What are your capabilities? What are you currently pursuing? And what kind of connections you have? What kind of posts you share with people? That is what they are looking for. Recruiters stick to live resume. So start branding yourself. It is the time. Don't start working on the, start working on the name and make it a brand. Just don't be XYZ person. Rather be someone that someone takes your name and has a brand image of your in their mind. It is a vast storehouse of knowledge. Okay, since it is pandemic, we have no access to libraries, though e-libraries are there. But, I have personally experienced that I have gained a lot of knowledge during this lockdown via social media, internet and everything, because we have suddenly switched to digitization. We have started digitization. So again, social media, because I have been following certain pages on Instagram, which help me know current trends that are going, current news that is going on. Not only news, what are the companies doing? How are they facing the challenges and how are they conquering the shortcomings that are their way? Because everything was unplanned. So it becomes social media again becomes a vast storehouse of knowledge for everybody. Then comes platform to showcase your talent. It is a platform to showcase your talent as, for example, I would like to quote example. My friend, she's very fond of, painting and then creating a story behind it. So what did she do? She created a page, mymusings.com, mymusings.in on Instagram. And now she's like, she's rising. She has rise like a phoenix. So she has showcased her talent. She puts every day something and every day a story behind it. So isn't it a good platform to showcase your talent? I've seen certain people posting their dance videos, certain people posting their cooking videos and lot many things. So it becomes a great platform to showcase your talent. Okay, do we have any questions till now here? Anybody? Any questions? Okay, no questions. Okay, then we'll move further. Where to start from? Where to start from using social media in a healthy way, in a professional way? So the first point here is switch from Facebook to LinkedIn. Facebook is not your best friend, trust me. LinkedIn is going to help you achieve great opportunities. It will even help you create opportunities for yourself. So I would request you to shift from Facebook to LinkedIn. Make LinkedIn your best friend and it will get you ample of opportunities. Then come start creating your presence. How do you create your presence on LinkedIn and social media? Like, what do you do when you have to create your presence on Instagram? Anybody from the audience, what do you do? Anybody from the audience, just give it a try. What do you do on Instagram to create your presence? Anybody, we have so many people. Anybody can give it a try. What do we do on Instagram to create our presence? Come on, guys, you can give it a try. Nobody?
Hello?
Yes,
Saksi. Yeah, hello?
Yeah, actually, people used to post their beautiful pictures on Instagram to present herself.
Exactly my point. What we post our prettiest pictures we can, we use certain hashtags, we tag certain people, and many things we do. But how to create your visual on LinkedIn and such professional profiles? Let the beauty of your brain come out here. What do you think? What do you feel? Like, in a way of professionalism, I'm talking about professionalism. What do you think about the current trends going on? If you've read something about it, quote it in 5 to 10 lines and then put it on your social media. If you find something motivating, which has motivated you, put on your LinkedIn profile, post it there. So that will help you create your presence. And if you read some good thing, you just like it and you share it with people, that will help you create your presence. The more you use it, the more you'll be, the more you read, the more you read people's posts, you like them, you reshare it. That will really help you create a presence on social media in terms of professionalism. Then comes the build healthy connections. Healthy connections again becomes an important point because it can bring you, opportunities at your door. It can help you create opportunities. It can also... what do you call it? It can be a, they can, you can find people who can be, you can read their career path because they post about it, and they can help you to achieve your career goals. So building healthy connections is again important. Then comes start spending time on LinkedIn. As I said, 30 minutes of your day, you should start spending on LinkedIn. 15 minutes after you wake up, 15 minutes before you sleep. This will really help you. 15 minutes, I think we can all, spare 15 minutes on LinkedIn. We spare hours, we spare hours of time on Instagram. We keep on scrolling. Yes, we do that. So can we just, take 30 minutes from that and we can use it for LinkedIn? Yes, we can. Personal branding. It will really help you to, make yourself a brand. LinkedIn is a great platform because personal branding is something to create an image that, yes, I have these skills, I have these capabilities, I have these certifications, I am currently working here, I am doing this, I have achieved this. It will help you to brand yourself. It will help you to acquire your dream job. Healthy connections, creating your presence, spending time on LinkedIn, and personal branding will help you to achieve your dream job and acquire higher position and job that you want. So that's it. Any questions? Any question from the audience? That's it from myself. At the end, I would like to say that you have to start, start spending some time on LinkedIn, use social media wisely, see the pros and cons. Every coin has to fight, but why don't we throw some light on the negative, positive side of it, which is helping people do wonders and create such beautiful impact on people. So I would suggest you to use your social media very wisely at this point of time. And it will help you achieve everything that you want in life. Okay, do we have any questions from the audience? Anybody?
Tanishka, there is no questions there, and it was really wonderful session today. And, I think you have your own next box, so we'll wind up here only.
Yes.
That fine?
Yes. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you so much for giving me this opportunity as well. Thank you so much.